Hello and welcome to VIT Community Radio 90.8 FM. This is Prashasti, your host for today's show, and you're listening to the very special program based on startups and entrepreneurship. Here today we have two very special guests, Professor Nakul Parameshwar, Assistant Professor, VIT Business School. Welcome, sir.
Thank you very much, Prashasti.
And Professor Murli Manohar, the Director, Library and the Senior Professor of VIT Business School, who has served in VIT since last 24 years. Very warm welcome to you too, sir.
Thank you and welcome.
Sir, we are here to talk about startups and how startups are being the new craze, the new word of the talk of the town nowadays. How students are approaching this word, how students are taking their professional life towards this new concept of starting a new startup, a business of their own, concept of entrepreneurship. I would like to ask Professor Murli Manohar, sir, what is your idea about students being going towards more towards entrepreneurship than taking a career as working under someone else?
Yeah, the concept of the startup itself is not a new. The terminology evolved. Otherwise, people are aware of setting up their own businesses. What transformation happened in India is the transformation of business to be done by a particular community to be a business to be done by anybody.
Yes.
Because the profession and the kind of activity that you need to do has the difference between that. The thin line has been, you know, disappeared. Today, anybody who has an idea can set up a business.
Yes.
Okay. That's where the transformation is. And when we look at it in terms of the how do I look at the opportunity? You know, how do I know that there is an opportunity for me to do business or to come up with an idea? What we need to be is we need to understand about our own surroundings.
Yes.
Look at what is happening around us. And every problem is an opportunity for you to do something. Now, I'll spell out little more details into that little later.
Sure. Okay, so coming, I would like to ask Professor Nakul. Sir, why do you think is this concept gaining so much interest in the people in this generation itself?
Okay, Prashasti, if you ask me this question, maybe the 21st generation youth are not looking at working under someone, right?
All right.
Because they are self-dependent, they are motivated enough to look at the future and say, let me determine what kind of future I want, rather than I getting into an organization, someone guiding me, and I'm working for my money, for a salary. So rather than looking at that, they are looking at a secondary dimension, which is evolving nowadays, which is like self-employment, take it up as an entrepreneurship, take it up as a startup, and leverage the opportunities, as Professor Murli Manohar also mentioned. Look at the pain points of people. And if you can provide for the pain point, you're a hit. Otherwise, it's a learning experience. Even failure is not a end to your life or end to your career. Maybe people move out from startup or entrepreneurship and then maybe joining a corporate afterwards also. So it's like a play field which most of the youth are trying out nowadays, so that they want to test themselves and say, do I have the metal? Do I have the courage? Do I have the resources? Do I have the opportunities? Do I have the strength to actually take it forward to a next level rather than just looking at a corporate career?
Exactly. As well, they also have this the risk of not knowing whether the business would succeed in the long term or not.
That is the if you ask me, that is a trade-off that they're doing, right? That's a trade-off, right? There's a risk always attached to it. And nowadays, you ask me again, 21st century thrills, speed thrills for them, right? Similarly, risk is one thing which is driving them, right? They are ready to take that risk for the returns that they might forecast. If they don't get it, they're okay with it also.
Yes.
Right. So now this 21st century generation is not risk averse in any dimension.
So as Nakul sir said, it's true that a lot of students are trying out after finishing their graduation and all, they're trying to start their own company because they're trying to have the self-employment concept come up into the scenario. And that's actually a good thing because being dependent at the point of business level is really hard, but taking the risk is always the first step. If you don't take the risk, you won't succeed. All right, so coming up to that, how, sir, I would like to ask Professor Murli, sir, how do you think the startups can change the world?
Yeah. As I said, you need to first identify a problem that you can work on. Okay. Let me just give you a simple example. If you look at the mosquitoes, which is a very, very small, tiny insect.
Yes.
Which is there for as old as the human history is, particularly in the tropical countries.
Yes.
If you look at that particular product, you know, the mosquito has helped people to come up with close to 20 different kinds of products.
Yeah, that's true.
Okay. So there is no end for that. You know, going back to the history, people started burning wood or maybe neem trees, neem leaves,
yes,
to make sure that the flame or the fragrance that comes out runs away these mosquitoes. To that stage, to creating a net, as the human history has evolved, we started developing knitting, you know, developing the thread and knitting, and net became a common phenomena. Then became the mosquito coils, mosquito, you know, repellents and things like.
Yeah.
So if you think that the problem is still not being solved, you come up with a unique solution, that is where you have an opportunity.
Yes, that's
okay.
True.
And the opportunity is not just lying only with this kind of products. It's there in high technology as well as in the day-to-day basic, you know, fulfilling the basic needs. So what you have to do is spot that particular problem on which you can solve the, you know, the evolve a solution for that. That's where your identity is. And why today's generation is taking up this as an, you know, as a important thing, it's because looking at the exposure that they have towards what is happening in the US, what is happening in the Europe. You know, when we see that Bill Gates can become world's richest guy when he is around 30 years, and he retired from Microsoft when he is 42, and he is now 50. He is now moved as the second richest guy in the world.
Yes.
What he has done is he just created a product which is existing already, but he made the life simple. That is what is the evolution of Microsoft is, the success of Microsoft is, right? So I have only one product, and with that particular product, I became the richest guy in the world.
Sure.
That is what drived many of the people. So the concept of startup, you know, picked up in Silicon Valley.
Yes.
Cascaded into many countries, typically into India, because we have fortunately a lot of young graduates coming out of the campuses.
Yes.
And many of these are also exposed towards these evolving organizations. That's where people are looking at. And there is a great opportunity for young, talented people in India to set up their own businesses.
True, sir. And when we talk about India, well, we're talking about here in VIT Community Radio. So even in VIT, we have this VIT Business School, and we have a curriculum, a course on Lean Startup Management, teaching all the students of VIT about the basics of startup. And Professor Nakul himself is taking the subject as a faculty, as well as Professor Murli. And so, sir, can you please tell me about what brought this subject, brought the idea of bringing the subject in the curriculum of all the students, making it compulsory for all the students? How did this idea come up?
Okay, firstly, I guess I need to clarify the difference between entrepreneurship as a course and lean startup management as a course. Right. So entrepreneurship as a course is much more traditional, right?
Okay.
It talks about basics of management and how to start a venture, look for funding and other stuff. But when you compare it to lean startup management, the difference lies in the point saying that, see, we need not have a perfect kind of product. We need not be perfect in terms of our business plan, in terms of our resources, financial, non-financial. That should not stop us from going ahead. So lean startup management per se as a subject gives you a lot of tidbits, directions, principles, guidelines for taking your half-baked ideas, half-baked products, half-baked services to the market so that you understand whether there is a value for this product or service, then churn your product accordingly as per the evolving needs of the customer. So if I take the example, for example, maybe Facebook,
right?
Initially, when it was launched, it was looked at as a social networking site for a university. When they took it outside to maybe a city level or a country level, they realized that a lot of things need to be changed as per the evolving needs of the customer at different levels.
Yes.
Right. So had they come from the traditional entrepreneurship side, if you look at lean startup management, it says that as soon as you have a viable product, go ahead. Don't restrict yourself. Go launch it to the market. Take the feedback, take the suggestions, comments from the customers. If you want, retreat for some time. Evolve your product and service to a level wherein you can cater to the needs of the customers, again go back. right? You even have a freedom to continue with a half-baked thing in the market and continually churn it within your organization. So lean startup management is more contemporary, more modern in approach, which comes from lean startup method given by Eric Ries and Steve Blank. So you'll find a lot of articles written on it for as well as against it, mentioning whether it's applicable in different market contexts or not. But if you look at lean startup management as a course, which is embedded in VIT, it gives you an impetus saying that, see, if I have an idea, why should I restrict myself and not try it ahead, right? Yeah. So it gives a urge to the student saying that, okay, if you have a very basic idea, go ahead, try to build on it and take it up ahead as a important startup or an entrepreneurial activity.
Yes, that is a very good initiative by VIT that can motivate a lot of students who have ideas but do not have a direction of where to take it or how to start. So teaching them the basics can prove to be very beneficial on the part of the students as well as the university, helping India to grow. Also, I would like to ask that VIT Business School has also has a number of courses regarding probably the management of startups and all. Can you elaborate a little bit about that, sir?
We don't have any special course as such, you know, startup management. This course is actually authored by, you know, faculty from the business school along with faculty from the technology management, which is an offshoot of the business school.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Looking at the requirements of the market. Uh-huh. How do we prepare? Because, you know, this is in line with the Prime Minister's urge for, you know, startup India.
Yes.
Okay. The concept is that, you know, India has at a, you know, beautiful stage where we have huge potential to create varieties of products and services, not just for India, but for the global markets.
Yes, true.
Okay. And the opportunity is there for every one of us. Now, it's for us to knock those doors.
Yes.
It's for the students to take this responsibility. That's what exactly VIT has, you know, taken up as a, you know, mission. Make everybody to go through this process. We know definitely we may not be successful in the initial part, but let's expose. Let's make everybody to understand there is a market, you know, just before us. It's for us to, you know, capture that. It's for us to come up with the creative solutions. It's for us to come up with innovative products, innovative services. And the globe is a market today.
Sure, sir.
So maybe just to add on to what Professor Murali sir mentioned, if you're looking at India as a market, the bottom of the pyramid concept by Prahlad, the thing is education systems should not seek for employment or seek for jobs.
Exactly.
They themselves should nurture jobs which can help the poor, right? Also looking at the needs, diverse wants, diverse needs of a emerging market economy like India, the timing of this course, especially in VIT, I guess we are setting the precedence across the country by having a very different course on startup management known as lean startup management. So we are actually trying it out and saying that why can't we set a precedence wherein we have all the engineering students take up this course and at least they get sensitized and they get a urge to take their basic minimum idea that is there in their mind, maybe take it forward, launch it and try and test it even before saying that it's not working. It's not a workable idea.
Sure, sir. Because it's a very general case, even in students. On a personal note, I can say that while coming to engineering, what the idea was that being the field that I've taken engineering, then further going on the last year will be sitting for placements, going for a job. That was the main idea. Never this idea of startups are being fed up through schools or parents or anywhere. So inculcating these ideas through such courses are really nice, and it'll be a lot more beneficial if all the colleges of India would start inculcating this course. And also an initiative by the government says that startup courses should be included in college courses, though they have not been made compulsory in all the colleges, but yes, they are there, only if everybody would be aware of that. Apart from that, I would like to talk about when we started our talk with startups and entrepreneurs. So coming to entrepreneurship, it is something very different. A person who is taking up entrepreneurship does not live a regular, typical life. It is way more different than a normal life. Because starting something up, taking up the initiative, finding investors for your startup, takes a lot of risk. Because starting, the beginning is always the hardest. Just to celebrate the confluence of emerging technology and entrepreneurship, there is this World Startup Fest that is organized every year, and this year it's being held in Bangalore through 15th to 20th of April, and it is basically meant to appreciate innovators, and it has a lot of hackathons, competition and conferences, and also the Global Startup Awards are given to the best startups from the SAARC countries and ASEAN countries startup, and let's see who gets the award this year. And everybody, I would like to tell all my audience that you can also register to go to this fest if you want, or you can just have the updates on Facebook or live online. Apart from this, in VIT also we have this VIT TBI, the incubator cell of VIT. So, Professor Murli, can you tell me something about this?
Yeah, VIT TBI is one of the first TBIs established in India.
Okay.
In the private sector. The Government of India, Department of Science and Technology has, you know, provided a seed fund for setting up this with an objective that we help budding entrepreneurs to come up, to convert their idea into, you know, a concept into a reality.
Okay.
And VIT TBI is very, very specialized in undertaking, you know, projects in biotechnology, information technology,
right,
and then environmental related issues. Okay.
Okay.
As on today in VIT TBI, you know, I'm part of the VIT TBI from the beginning as one of the mentors. I take part as a resource person, train the trainer. Now I train a lot of trainers who come from different parts of India.
Right.
So I'm proud to be part of the VIT TBI, as I always say, VITN. Once a VITN, always a VITN.
Yes.
True to the spirit, you know, we take part in every activity of the VIT TBI. So with confidence, I can tell that VIT TBI helped in shaping up 27 ventures. 27 ventures as on today, they have graduated.
Okay.
From, they came with the concept. VIT TBI is not just only meant for VITNs, students or graduates or the alumni. It's open for everybody and anybody. Anybody who is walking through this street or from this city, this country, can walk in with the idea. We are there to provide you with the support. We provide you the cubicle. We provide you the mental support. The mentor, we are going to be provided with the VIT. And VIT TBI also provides the seed fund for taking your idea into a reality.
All right.
Okay.
That's a very nice initiative by VIT. But there have also been a lot of cases where students do have ideas. A lot of, as we know, India has a lot of talent and a lot of students have many ideas. But there is a point when, even though the idea is good enough, the student is not motivated enough to bring the idea and turn the idea into reality. A lot of students just, even though they are offered the course or even though they are given a lot of, they have the opportunity of getting mentorship and all, but they do not go anyway. The student himself or herself has to approach the opportunity. So what is it that you think, especially in India, what is it stopping them, or what do you think they are thinking that would be a lot challenging for their startup so that they don't even give it a try?
So you're looking at the mental blockages that affects the students, the better word, the mental blockage.
Yeah,
I guess it's embedded in our minds from the traditional nature of upbringing in the family. So we are said that, okay, you want to do engineering right at the right when you get into, say, higher secondary or something, your path is defined. Okay, you want to get into engineering. Okay, once you get into engineering, what next? Okay, computer science, the hit of the day, whatever be the area, you specialize in that and then go ahead and maybe you are looking at getting a job.
Yes.
Right. The mental blockage starts from the traditional way of upbringing, which is gradually changing. I'm not saying that it will not change. It will take a lot of time, wherein the whole family setup, parents, brothers, sisters, relatives, all of them appreciate the fact that one of the family members is trying to create something new, and maybe it can have a value for not only for the customers, but it can provide jobs for a lot many people. And looking at ahead, maybe 30, 40 years down the line, it can be one of the Tatas, Birlas, or one of the Ambanis.
Yes.
Right. So the mental blockage is basically based on the basic level of education that we get, traditional upbringing. There's nothing wrong in it. I'm not criticizing it for the negative part. But we need to evolve from both angles, right? On the higher education angle, as well as the primary level education angle. Because students should be given the opportunity to express themselves, first of all, so that they can come out and speak confidently. Even if the idea is going to fail, you should have that, you should own that idea. And when you come and speak it up, you should have the confidence saying that, yes, this idea will work it out. So those things have to be inculcated in a student right from the primary level of education, nurtured during the secondary level, and further when they come into a university or a institution for higher education, the faculty is there, the system there should identify the potential that these students have and direct them to the appropriate path. Okay, if you cannot have a startup, okay, it's fine. But if there is a spark in this child, in this student, who has an idea that can be taken up ahead, maybe institutions like TBI within VIT is nurturing such ideas.
Yes.
So it will gradually, we will improve. Gradually, we will improve. So now the government is coming up and saying startup initiative, Startup India, Stand Up India, all these stuff are coming from the government as policy initiatives. So gradually, people, not only from the urban centers, but gradually people from the rural centers will also come up with their own ideas, start speaking it out, look at the potential and then launch it ahead. So it's just that it will take time. As an emerging market, in any emerging market, it will take time. When you are trying to have something new come up, something similar is happening in India. Startup as a concept is there. Entrepreneurship as a concept is there. But startup by a youngster trying to really make it big will take some time to seep in with everyone, right? The family, the society, the customers. So all these aspects need to be taken care.
Yes, true. I would like to ask now both of you about what, starting with Professor Murli, what brought you into this field of business school? What was your motivation that might inspire other students to come to this field of taking part in business school?
Yeah, I got into VIT Business School. I was the first faculty to join.
All right.
So even before the program started, we joined. Me and my colleague, Dr. Gomati, two of us who joined here before the program started. So after the program started, so technically I am with VIT for the last 24 years.
Yeah.
In the last 24 years, I had an opportunity of spending close to 4 years across the globe. I taught in 4 continents in the last 24 years. And also 1 year in IIM Ahmedabad. So, that has given me a great opportunity to evolve myself from what I was. Both the global experience as well as the studying or the spending 1 full year in the IIM Ahmedabad made me to understand the kind of contemporary issues that we need to look at. And today I believe that business graduates, whether it is engineering graduate or the business graduate, need to learn a lot of things. Okay, the first thing that they have to develop is understand what is happening around us.
Yes.
One of the best means of doing it is reading a newspaper. My suggestion to all of you should be to read newspaper.
Yes.
Whatever is of interest to you, start developing that habit. Because that helps you to develop 2 things. One, your reading capability. Second, your ability to grasp things which are there. Start reading only what interests you. If I'm interested in cricket, just start reading only about cricket. It helps you to develop your pronunciation, your reading capability, your lot of new words, how people present.
Yes,
sir.
Because
end of the day, what are we going to be? In any profession, we need writing skills. Communication is one of the most important deciding factor of somebody getting a job or not getting a job. Somebody is successful in their life or not.
True.
So, not just devote full time towards your WhatsApp and things like, spend time towards reading newspapers. Second, what I learned from IIM Ahmedabad, even Nakul will agree that in IITs, all of us who graduated from these top-notch institutes in the country, we never study a textbook for any course.
Okay.
We learn a lot of new things. I, in fact, don't recommend a textbook for any course.
Alright.
What you are expected to do is, there is a better way of learning. One of the better way of learning is reading from research articles, research reports.
That's true.
Okay. So you have to develop this habit of reading these kinds of content. Fortunately, being a director, I can tell you, or the director of the library, I can tell you, all our e-resources are made available for all the VITians to study at any time, anywhere. While traveling, you can do this today we have put everything into the Remotex through a one-point portal where we have pushed all the content into cloud. So all our VITNs can access all the material that is available, both in the form of e-journals, e-books, and databases. And you need to develop this habit of reading.
Yes.
Because you don't know when something is useful to you to make a better presentation.
Choose.
Okay. So these are my two suggestions for every VITN. Spend time towards reading newspaper. Start developing. There is a lot of learning can happen, not just reading textbooks.
Yes.
I'm not suggesting that you should not, but you can learn better if you read, because research articles will present the future trends. Most of the reports will talk about that.
Choose.
You are not prepared for today, you are prepared for the future.
Future.
So that's the takeaway from me.
Yes, thank you, sir. Coming to Nakul, sir.
If you ask me, I am the youngest and the newest member at VIT Business School. Recently joined some 6 months back after submitting my thesis at IIT Delhi. If I look at my career and how I landed up here, it's a very roller coaster ride. So one thing is sure, if I look at back maybe last 15 years of my life, one thing that I want to convey to the whole fraternity is, if you have certain apprehensions, certain challenges which you think that you cannot take it on, then you should surely take it on, right?
Yes.
It's the thing that if something is getting in your way and saying that, see, we will not let you do this thing, right? We should surely cater to that, try to overcome that challenge. So one thing which helped me to come up to this space is, maybe I have failed in multiple things. I will fail in multiple things ahead in my life also. I know that. But the failure should not be a deciding force for my further actions, right? You should have that never say die kind of attitude, right?
Yes.
Which cannot be taught by any faculty. It needs to be, inculcated by the person himself or herself, by experiences. So if I am saying that I have a never say die kind of attitude, I preach it, I follow it myself, right? It doesn't mean that one of the failures will affect my next thing that I'm doing, which I see as a very important aspect in today's youth. They take one failure for granted and sit down, get bogged down, get depressed and all those stuff.
Yes.
Which should not happen, right? It's not the end of your life. It's not an end of your career. One failure, few failures, many failures, you have to expect, you have to be prepared for all these stuff.
Sure.
And if you ask me, management education is both an art and a science. It's not absolutely a science. So at times, we as faculties try to leave the students in a state of turbulence, or we leave them in an abstract way, so that we leave ample opportunities to the students to make their own understanding, right? That is very important. You need to make the students think. So the students by themselves need to think, as sir mentioned, by reading newspapers. At least you start thinking in one or the other dimension, right? Maybe biased, maybe unbiased, can be debatable. But once you start reading newspapers, the very basic level, and go ahead, read HBR articles, then go ahead, read research articles, it will shape up your thought process, not only for today, but to take on challenges for the future. The second dimension is the never say die attitude.
Yes.
The third is, what is it that you want to do in life? Many of the students don't have a vision in their life. I'm not saying vision means you have to have a very concrete one-line statement of a vision. No. But you need to have at least a path, right? There's a very age-old story regarding Alice in the Wonderland. I like to quote this in class also. So Alice is lost in the woods, and she's walking along the woods and she gets lost, and she has two paths in front of her, and she starts thinking, what should she actually do right now? And at that moment, a Cheshire cat appears. Cheshire cat is a cat with magical powers. So she goes ahead and asks the Cheshire cat which path she should take. The Cheshire cat replies that it depends on where you want to go.
True.
So Alice is taken aback. She again thinks for a second and says to the Cheshire cat that it doesn't matter where I go. The Cheshire cat replies, then it doesn't matter which path you take. So the vision, or the aim, or the aspiration, whatever word you give it, is the driving force. it doesn't matter whether you're doing an engineering course or management course, any other course, right? Until and unless you have a vision or an aim or an aspiration, it's quite difficult to put in your efforts in the right direction.
True, sir. Right? Very true. All right. It was very inspiring, both of your stories and both of your inspirational words, both of your teachings that you said that the students should read more, and the attitude or the vision that the students should have. That was really nice and very inspirational and motivating for all my audience. And here we are coming towards the end of the program, and that was really nice. And I would like to say my audience that very truly that our professors just said, just do not stop yourself at the thought of having an obstacle right in front of you, because you might see that obstacle which might be hiding a very bigger opportunity right behind it. So just go for it if you feel it, and all the obstacles that you have to take over might succeed you and take you very far in life. But well, that was all, and thank you all for listening, and keep listening to VID Community Radio 90.8 FM, and this is Precious T signing off.